If you've installed and activated WP Rocket on your website, the first thing you'll want to do is check that it's working as expected. In this video, we'll look at four simple methods to check that WP Rocket is caching and optimizing your pages. By default, WP Rocket delivers cached pages for visitors who are not logged in. So when you're checking to see that caching is working as expected, make sure you're logged out first. You can also use a private or incognito browser window if you prefer. The first method is to look for WP Rocket's caching footprint. Open the browser's source view of the page and scroll to the bottom. At the very end, you should see an entry like this. The next method is to use the Wappalyzer extension to detect if WP Rocket is enabled. Wappalyzer is a free utility that lets you identify the underlying technology that powers a website. You can install the extension in your web browser and then just select the icon while visiting your site to see if WP Rocket is listed under the cache tools. Now, if your site is using CloudFlare, you may not see the WP Rocket footprint or see it listed in Wappalyzer. That's because CloudFlare removes this footprint when it minifies the HTML. So if you're using CloudFlare, here's another method to check that WP Rocket is activated. If you've enabled the options to minify CSS files or JavaScript files, you can look for WP Rocket in the minified file. First, be sure you're logged out. Then, open the source view of the page in your browser and look for the head section. URLs that end with CSS or JS should include a path to the folder named min inside the cache folder, which is located within the WP-content folder. This means that WP Rocket's file optimization is working. So this page is being cached. All right, there's one more method to check if WP Rocket is caching your site. You can look for the cache folders and files on your server. First, make sure you're logged out, and then visit several pages on your site so they get cached. Using an FTP application, or the file manager in your web hosting control panel, connect to your WordPress site directory. Then, open the WP-content folder or directory, then the cache folder, and finally, the WP-rocket folder. Now you should see another folder with your domain name. In this folder, you should find cached HTML or HTML gzip files, along with folders for each page on your site. These are the cache files. After using all these methods, if you determine that WP Rocket is not caching your site, click the help beacon for a list of troubleshooting tips, or contact our support team. They'll be more than happy to help you get up and running. Once you've determined that WP Rocket is caching your site, you'll probably want to run a speed test to see just how fast your site is loading. So in our next video, we'll show you how to do just that.